In addition to producing a long string of hit singles in the 60s and 70s, Ted worked with Van Morrison, the Doobie Brothers, Eric Clapton, and his all-time idol, Aerosmith, Carly Simon, and of course, Fleetwood Mac, among others, producing some of the most groundbreaking and unprecedented albums of that time. By 77, his position as a legendary producer was cemented. Side of the EP was the tracklist, Runners of the Devil, Corruption, Ice Cream Man, Really Got Me, and Jamie's Truck. Well, on the other side, the limited number of the version of Looney Tunes Royal Bill. The EP had precisely the desired effect, gaining considerable airplay, whetting the public's appetite for the band and the promise of a new opportunities that we were talking about. So, while I had developed a layer of
truck.
I didn't ask for this to be I don't give a shit what the man sounded like. Carl said they were good. And that was all I needed to hear. Especially if he wanted to hire me as their tour manager. I trusted his thing. This, by the way, was a promotion I did not expect, and certainly did not anticipate when I sat down in Carl's office. I only knew that Carl liked leaders, and that he'd expressed an unusual degree of confidence in these four young men from Pasadena. In fact, as Carl gushed on and on about them, I thought that this was too good to be true. But you see, this was hard, just fucking amazing. The front man is incredible. And by the way, I got them for a steal. This last part was too active. Sounds fantastic, I said. I can't wait to meet him. Glad to hear it, Noel, he said. But you're having lunch with him next week. Chapter 2. Van Halen Unleashed. I can't believe it, really. That's what I remember thinking as I sat at a table in a restaurant in Irvine with Carl Scott, Ted Cohen, and a member of the Warner Brothers publicity department. Four of us were supposed to meet with the guys from Van Halen at 1 in the afternoon. Now, I understood as well as anyone that the majority of musicians have only a tenuous grasp on the concept of time, so punctuality is generally not to be expected. I hope this would be different. The band, young, eager, and on the cusp of stardom, having just received its big break, a band whose first album was scheduled to be released on a major label within the next month. Band that soon would be embarking on a major tour to support Sam. You would think, or at least hope, that a band in this situation would show up for a meeting with its bosses and new tour manager on time, or maybe even a little early. You'd be wrong. I looked at my watch. 1:10. Then I looked at it a bunch of times. 1:15. 1:20. Some sort of athletic event and lost. David naturally did most of the talking, as would be the case for the next 7 years, though he was far more subdued in that moment than the man I would come to know. He apologized on behalf of himself and his friends and explained that no disrespect was intended. The car broke down on the way over, and he seemed rather sheepishly. No, right? Actually, no. As the meeting went on, I came to the conclusion that these guys were probably telling the truth. Their car really had broken down, and they really had legged it all the way across town to the meeting. It was one of those things that showed the kind of dedication needed to make an impression in a business like this. Whatever it takes, you do. They didn't carry themselves with the slightest bit of arrogance or hubris. Seem downright shy and humble. Not exactly what I come to expect of musicians in general, and certainly not from a band that had been so highly touted by Carl Scott. I expected these guys to strut into the restaurant like kings, as if they believed that rock and roll was theirs for the taking. Given what I've heard, and I'm not talking about the music, I still hadn't heard a single Van Halen song, I expected them to be self-assured, not downright cocky. They weren't. They were a quartet of long-haired kids in tattered jeans and worn boots.